Hi and welcome to this week's Tech Talk. Today we're going to be looking at one of the ways in which an online dual conversion UPS system provides protection to the critical load which is connected to its output. Now the primary purpose of a UPS is to ensure that should the incoming main supply to the UPS system fail, then the UPS will ensure that the supply to the critical load remains present at all time. Now this is referred to as no break, because when the main supply fails, the output to the critical load remains completely unaffected. Now exactly what do I mean by no break? Well, if we take a look at the oscilloscope, I can show you in a little bit more detail. Okay, so if we take a look at the oscilloscope here, the waveform that we have across the top here is effectively the main supply that's coming into the UPS. The waveform along the bottom is the waveform that has been supplied to the critical load and hence the protected side of the UPS. Now, if I slow the trace down, like so, and then fail the main supply to the UPS, I can stop the trace and effectively capture the moment when the main supply fails. Now, if I zoom into that moment, like so, you can see that even though the main supply has failed, the output from the UPS system remains completely unaffected. Now, if I return that process, in that we return the main supply back onto the UPS, like so, if I slow down my trace once again and reapply that main supply, and again stop the trace, if I zoom into that trace, again, even though the main supply has returned, the output voltage waveform from our UPS system remains completely unaffected. Okay, so if we take a look at the diagram of the board here, this effectively is a basic block diagram of an online dual conversion UPS system. Now, the online dual conversion UPS system operates simply by taking the voltage from the incoming main supply, converting that voltage from AC to DC via the rectifier. Then we reinvert that voltage back from DC back to AC again via the inverter in order to supply that voltage to the critical load. Now, in between the rectifier output and the inverter input are connected the batteries. Now, depending on the type of UPS, we'll determine how those batteries are connected. Some systems will use a direct connection where the batteries are connected directly onto the DC bus. Some systems will use an IGBT-based switching technology via a buck boost system, and some systems will just utilize a thyristor-based switching mechanism. Regardless of which, when the main supply on the incoming side of the UPS system fails, the power being provided from the rectifier will also fail. Now, the purpose of the rectifier is to ensure that the inverter, which is providing our AC voltage, is provided with a continuous source of electrical energy. However, if the main supply has failed, that is no longer available, and therefore the UPS system must absorb that power from the connected batteries. However, once the main supply fails, there is a delay in which the UPS system can transfer the power from the output of the rectifier onto the batteries. Now, if the delay is too big, a break in the supply to the critical load will occur. Now, inside each UPS system, there are devices referred to as capacitors, and its symbol basically is similar to a battery, but with two vertical lines of the same length. Now, a capacitor is very similar to a battery. However, a battery is a chemical reaction, which is providing power for a prolonged period of time, whereas a capacitor will only give us back what we put into it, minus losses, etc. Now, the purpose of a capacitor is to ensure that whilst we're transferring between the rectifier output and onto the batteries, the capacitor will hold up that DC rail for a long enough time so that we can make that transfer and the inverter does not see any disruption in the source of electrical power. And therefore, the inverter can continue operating and hence continue providing the protected load with a clean source of electrical power. And therefore, when the main supply returns, again, the process is simply returned. And so therefore, inside the UPS, we have banks of capacitors, which can bridge that gap when the main supply fails and then we transfer onto battery, and vice versa. Well, I hope you found this tech talk useful. If you have a question that you would like us to answer here at Riello, then please email us on techtalk@riello-ups.co.uk. Thank you.